This video is sponsored by
DFRobot. Future.
Hello YouTube and welcome to Heathen Hacks. If you're here from the previous video, glad to see you back. I assume that you've just finished project number 10. Well, I mean, considering how late this video is, I really hope so. Let's move on to project number 11, our controllable servo. Previously, we've seen how easy it is to control it by setting up fixed values on its code. This time, we're going to control it using a 10K potentiometer. Let's go! Here are the things that we're going to need for this project. As per usual, our DF Arduino board, followed by the prototyping shield, male-to-male jumper cables, female-to-male jumper cables, 9G micro servo, and of course, a 10K potentiometer. Moving on to the wiring phase, first, let's get our DF Arduino board. Mount the prototyping shield on top of it. Let's get our 10K potentiometer and attach it like this. Next, let's get our servo and jumper cables ready. Connect the black jumper cable to the servo's brown pin or ground. Connect the red jumper cable to the servo's red pin or 5 volts. Then, connect the green jumper cable to the servo's yellow pin or data. After that, let's connect the black jumper cable to DF Arduino's ground pin, red jumper cable to DF Arduino's 5 volts, and then the green jumper cable to DF Arduino's digital pin number 9. Followed by the 10K potentiometer, let's connect this blue jumper cable to DF Arduino's analog pin number 0, red jumper cable to 5 volts, and then of course, black one to ground. And that's it for the wiring phase. Here's the sample code. Much like the sketch from the previous project, this one is really short as well, but we'll discuss that later. For now, let's do some code demo. Okay, let's plug in our board to the computer. Make sure that the MCU is being detected and we're on the correct port. Click on verify, then upload the code. There we go. So upon uploading the sketch, the servo turned automatically according to what value the potentiometer is currently set on, or to what value the analog pin is reading from it. And since we have connected the 5 volts to the right leg of the potentiometer, I think it's safe to say that the potentiometer is currently receiving 0 volts. That's why the servo turned 180 degrees to the left when it was first powered on. Now, if we take a closer look, as I turn the potentiometer knob, the servo goes along with it. If I turn it to the right, it turns right. And if I turn it to the left, it turns to the left. There's a bit of a delay though, because the board keeps on disconnecting and reconnecting at every turn. Not really sure if it was because the USB port on my PC can provide it with enough juice or something. But yeah, that's pretty much it, really. Here's how the code works. As previously discussed, we first need to declare or call the servo library and servo objects.
I suggest watching project number 10 if you haven't yet.
The pot pin variable is where the potentiometer is connected to, which is on DFRobot's analog pin number 0. The variable val here will be used to store the values from pot pin. Moving on to void setup. Again, as we have previously discussed on project number 10, my servo.attach is where the servo is attached, which is on DFRobot's digital pin number 9. Onto the void loop, we have the variable val that is set up to read the value or data from analog pin number 0 or pot pin, and then convert it from 0 to 5 volts into integer values between 0 to 1023. Turning the knob all the way to either direction, left or right, changes the resistances between the center and the two outside pins and gives a different voltage value at the analog pin. For example, when the knob is turned all the way to the right and your 5V supply is connected to the third pin of the potentiometer, which is on the right side, there would be zero resistance between the center pin and the 5V supply, which would then turn the voltage at the center pin to 5V. 5V would then be converted by the analog read command and change the voltage value to analog, which would make it 1023. And would make it 0 if the knob is turned all the way to the left, because that is where the ground connection is. However, if the potentiometer's knob is at the middle position, analog read returns a number between 0 and 1023 that is proportional to the amount of voltage being applied to the pin. Val equals map val 0 1023 0179. This line of code right here represents the mapping of the potentiometer value or pot pin from 0 to 1023 or 0 to 179. The map function has 5 parameters, namely value from low, from high, to low, and to high. Val is the value or the number to map. 0 is the from low or the lower bound of the value's current range. And 23 is the from high or the upper bound of the value's current range. The other 0 is the to low or the lower bound of the value's target range. And then lastly, 179 or the upper bound of the value's target range. Simply put, 0 to 1023 are the converted voltage values from the analog read command and 0 to 179 are the mapped values from the analog read. In this case, we map the analog read's converted values to degrees because we're going to need it to control the orientation of the servo's arm. Continuing on, after the map function, we have myservo.writeVal and a delay of 15 milliseconds which we have already discussed on previous projects. That's it!
Thank you so much!
Just to recap, the value from analog read, which is between 0 and 1023, would be mapped to values that are usable by the servo. I know that it can be quite confusing, so for a more in-depth explanation, please refer to the PDF. Click right here if you feel ready to move on to the next project. See ya!